अ वेरी गुड ओ'क्लॉक डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आई एम निकिता मैम, योर ज्योग्राफी टीचर. स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडेज वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज़ अ ड्रेनेज सिस्टम एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स ऑफ ड्रेनेज ऑफ अ रिवर. एंड देन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑन विद व्हाट बेसिस वी कैन क्लासिफाई सम ड्रेनेज सिस्टम्स. ओके, टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आवर मेन टॉपिक, दैट इज़ द टू ड्रेनेज सिस्टम्स ऑफ इंडिया. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टू ड्रेनेज सिस्टम ऑफ इंडिया आर द Himalayan drainage system and the peninsular drainage system. So these two broad divisions of drainage in India can be recognized on the basis of their evolution. Okay, how they have evolved. So these are the Himalayan rivers and second is the peninsular rivers. So before we proceed to know about the present nature of the drainage system, it is necessary to understand its evolution, means how these drainage systems were firstly formed. Okay, so present drainage system of India is the result of a long process of evolution. Okay, so first of all, coming about the evolution of the Himalayan drainage, basic information that Himalayan drainage system has a long geological history. The most important rivers are Ganga, Indus and Brahmaputra. Okay, these three rivers form this whole Himalayan basin along with their tributaries and distributaries. Okay, these rivers, since these rivers are fed both by melting of snow and precipitation, rivers of this system are perennial. Okay, what are the perennial natured rivers? Perennial natured rivers are those which are full of water all throughout the year. Okay, because these have been fed by, or these are filled by the melting of snow glaciers and also by the precipitation when they come to the ground, hence they never get dried up totally. Okay, so these are known as the perennial rivers. Okay, now coming to the evolution of this Himalayan drainage. Last point is that rivers from giant gorges, V-shaped valleys, rapids, waterfalls in their mountainous course, and while entering the plains, they form depositional features like flat valleys, oxbow lakes and floodplains. Okay, so since they are coming from a higher slope, the speed of the rivers while coming from the higher slope is very high and fast pace. That is why they form V-shaped valleys, gorges, rapids, waterfalls, these kinds of course, these kinds of features during their mountainous course, and when they land in the flats or the plains, then they form the flat features like the depositional features like valleys, oxbow lakes and floodplains. Okay, hope that is clear. Now evolution of the Himalayan drainage. So geologists believe that a mighty river called Shivalik or Indo-Brahma transfers the entire longitudinal extent of Himalaya from Assam to Punjab and onwards to Sindh. So this is basically known as the Indo-Brahman theory. Okay, the Indo-Brahm theory. So according to geologists, the Shivalik hills run parallel to the main Himalayan ranges and are formed of alluvial deposits containing of sand, clays and boulders conglomerates. So these deposits were laid down by a mighty stream which flowed from Assam to Punjab, even beyond up to the Sindh. Okay, so this covered a whole longitudinal extent of the Himalaya from Assam to Punjab and onwards to the Sindh, and finally it discharged into the Gulf of Sindh near lower Punjab during the Miocene period, that is some 5 to 24 million years ago. Okay, so that is the long story of evolution of the drainage system of Himalaya. Second point is that the remarkable continuity of the Shivaliks and its lacustrine origin and alluvial deposits, means the origin from the deposits of the river, okay, consisting of sand, silt, clay, boulders and conglomerates, support this point of view. Okay, in due course of time, Indo-Brahma river were dismembered into three main drainage system. Okay, existence of Shivalik ranges support this Indo-Brahma theory, because it is believed that these Shivalik ranges or the Tarai region, which we called as, was formed due to the depositional work of this important river, that is the Indo-Brahma river, which then got divided into three main rivers, the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Okay, so this drainage system divided into three main drainage system, the Indus and its five tributaries in the western part, that is Satluj, Chenab, Ravi, Jhelum. Okay, and the Ganga and its Himalayan tributaries in the central parts. Then the stretch of Brahmaputra in Assam and Himalayan tributaries in the eastern part. Okay, so this dismemberment was probably due to why this whole large river divided into these three river systems. That was probably due to the Pleistocene upheaval in the western Himalayas, including the uplift of Potwar Plateau, that is the Delhi Ridge, which acted as the water divide between the Indus and Ganga drainage system. Okay, means during the long course of time when there was a disturbance in the Himalayas, okay, and the Potwar Plateau, that is today known as Delhi Ridge, came out of the ranges, and it acted as a water divide between the Indus and Ganga drainage system. So this Delhi Ridge, or the Potwar Plateau as we called it today, is basically formed from the Aravali and the Sahyadri ranges. Okay, so these ranges act as a divide between the peninsula rivers and the Himalayan rivers. Okay, so these were the Indus and Ganga drainage system के बीच का ये डिवाइड है, वाटर डिवाइड है. सो दिस वॉज द मेन रीज़न, दिस वॉज द मेन रीज़न ऑफ द स्प्लिट ऑफ द इंडो ब्रह्म रिवर इंटू दीज थ्री रिवर सिस्टम्स. देन लाइकवाइज द डाउन थर्स्टिंग ऑफ द मालदा गैप बिटवीन द राजमहल हिल्स एंड द मेघालय प्लेटू ड्यूरिंग द मिड प्लेस्टोसिन पीरियड डाइवर्टेड द गंगा एंड ब्रह्मपुत्र सिस्टम टू फ्लो टवर्ड्स द बे ऑफ बंगाल. ओके, then another thing which happened to be a major reason of this split was that the Malda gap sank down, which was a gap between the Rajmahal Hills and the Meghalaya Plateau during the mid-Palestine period. Then this diverted the Ganga and Brahmaputra routes to flow into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, it means towards the east, which then became the eastward extension of the Brahmaputra.